Manisha, thank you for being here.
Pleasure. Well, it's great to be back here. I've been visiting Ahmedabad for last 2 years ago, very frequently, when we were opening ITC Narmada. But it's always a delight to come back to this beautiful state.
ITC Sabarmati, we should call it, no?
Well, we've called it ITC Narmada, I'm sure.
It is the water of the Narmada.
Some thought behind it.
So, Chef, what are we making today?
So what we are doing, I was listening to all this at the earlier discussion also that was happening, that how the footprints of the various royal families have kind of merged together and how they have been able to take that those flavors from different parts of the country, whether it is Karnataka or Nepal or Agra or wherever. So I don't think we should limit ourselves to using various cooking techniques, what is available, what is fresh in the market. So I thought, since millet is the mantra, the whole world has been talking about mantra, about millet. Even during G20, wow, we have a guest here. So even during G20, we had created millet-based menus. Of course, for the cat also, we are going to do that. We had created millet-based menu for around 42 world leaders. So I thought this is a great opportunity. I'm in Gujarat. It's a very rich state of millet. So let's do something with millet, but let me do something innovative. I definitely can't cook traditional khakhra and thepla the way you guys cook. That's not my forte. So I wanted to play safe. So we are doing a millet tacos filled with what is locally available here, findalia, the prickly red pear that you have, and of course the red guava. We are going to create something very different. I wanted to reach out to the younger generation which is sitting here, because I know they keep looking for something new that is in the market. And yet I wanted to stick to something which is healthier, which is local, which is fresh, and definitely not from the cans.
So it's Jenny friendly, is it? All the buzzwords come in. Jenny taco, is it Jenny taco?
What is Jenny taco?
Without garlic, onion, and...
Oh, Jenny taco. No. This definitely has onion and garlic. Of course, you can always omit it in your recipe. Yeah.
So, chef, cuisine, does it have to be didactic? Does it have to remain in a rajwada? Isn't food very democratic?
Food is very democratic. I think even if you look at the cookery techniques, I think it's no longer limited to those gharana recipes. Everything is very...
modern,
very fluid, very modern. People do try different things. I heard the earlier panel discussing that they still make French food in the house and they're very proud of it.
Crepe Suzette, he said.
Crepe Suzette, that's right. So I don't think one should limit oneself. Yes, you must keep the purity of your food alive. You must keep your tradition alive. But don't shy away from trying something unique and different also at the same time. Otherwise, there'll be no creativity, there'll be no innovation happening in the culinary world.
So you're very lucky. You won't be getting that spanking on your hand. I was told by Rani Sahiba from the Rana Sahiba. Rani Rana, she told us. Chawal, no. Or was it Asma who said rice can't be mixed with roti. So your taco has no rice, no?
My taco has no rice. But it definitely has millet. It definitely has bajra.
You
it
can speak for two more minutes.
But no more spanking here because you're not my father-in-law.
So no spanking. So what all does it have? Tell us. Ye grain hai.
So we've got different kind of grains here. We've got finger millet powder. We've got pearl millet powder. We've got a bit of ajwain and bit of zira. Ajwain and zira.
Flavor and health both.
Flavor and health both. Ajwain is more for digestion and of course zira for flavor. We've got the dough already pre-made because I didn't want to...
You're channeling your inner Sanjeev Kapoor.
Sanjeev Kapoor is here. The she Sanjeev Kapoor.
So it's all TV cooking. So in your home, you'll be kneading it. Aap aate ki tarah goondenge.
Yeah, aap aate ki tarah goondenge and then you will roll it. And either you roast it, dry roast it. Air fry is very fashionable nowadays. Or you can fry it. You can make it into a shell shape. We try to get it.
Oh, yeah, you have these.
It's right here. It's roasted.
Mere to daant toot gaye the isko khate samay.
Aapne khaya tha?
Aapne chakha ki nahi?
Maine khaya.
It's amazing. Look how pliable this is. Chef, you really have made it like a vehicle.
It is just a vehicle. In this you can put anything that you want, whatever you wish to. Like this recipe also just came. I was just thinking day before yesterday what to make. I'm going to Ahmedabad. Who am I to teach them vegetarian? But I said, let me just think of something, what is local, what is available, and this is what we did.
It's a millet kulle ki chaat.
Yeah, you can do that. You do makai. Makai is very widely available here. You do that khicha, makai ka khicha. You can put that on top of this and put any flavor, any pickle, whatever you want to do. Like I said, food is all about creativity. As long as you're not crossing the border, as long as you're not putting something which is absolutely different, like a nori or a
no,
ginger.
But
or
dal sushi has become the rage.
Well, I know Ahmedabad is very, very creative. I've been pestering my chef of ITC Narmada to take me to that food street for the night drive, because I know they do a lot of creative stuff. So hence we did try to do something different, and let's start with that.
Let's start. So what are we cooking first?
So we are going to make the dough first. You're going to roll the dough. And we're going to do the filling at the same time. Since this is already being done, she'll just roll one and show you how it's done.
And what oil do you use in your kitchen, chef?
In the hotels, we use, of course, Swasti, ITC Swasti ghee. We definitely use mustard oil. We do use olive oil. And refined oil is normally used for frying purposes.
Wonderful. And there's no harm in using fat that's refined?
I would like to stay away from refined, but like I said, for commercial purposes, it's better to use refined when you are in a commercial kitchen. But at home, I only do desi ghee or sarso ka tel.
Wo aapki wo skin,
skin, yeah, it's already so old.
No, glowing. So while she makes the atta, ye sabziyan bahut exotic hai, maine to kabhi dekhi nahi, kya hai? Ye to gaay charti hai. Ye kya
hai? Gaay charti hai, yeah, bilkul, this is very fashionable.
What this is this? Cow food, cow fodder.
Well, that's what you think.
What are you doing, chef?
We are creating a salad along with the tacos for the people to have.
I love it. And it gets crunch?
It gives you the crunch. It gives you the right roughage that you need. Because we all talk about roughage. I heard about the meatless Mondays and the vegetarian mantra that we all must follow. So it's important to add roughage. That's something I actually don't believe in so much, the avocado. In fact,
avocado.
I told them,
it's avocado.
Avocado. I told them not to put on the display because it takes so much of water. It takes so much of water. So I try to always find an alternate to avocado.
And what is it?
Avocado. This, so we did take some guava here. We did take some findalia, the prickly red pear.
And you pureed them?
You pureed them. These are very small pear. I don't know how many. I saw it for the first time yesterday. But I was searching, I came across that and I said, let me use that.
So can I say that women are the mothers of invention? Because, you know, in Cucina Povera in Italy, they say that the mothers of Italian cooking, in Italian homes, they developed recipes that were sensible, practical, using what was growing. And they didn't cook thinking a recipe here. They adapted. Can we say that women are more inventive than men?
It's unfair to say, get into gender here.
She's
first
so
of all.
Good. Oof, I was trying to make her say
it's
women
are unfair to get into gender here. Because women cook at home, they find new ways to innovate. If a man starts cooking at home as well, he will find
an answer.
So then
you're saying what I'm saying, you just don't want to say it.
Well. No, because I cook at home as well. There are times when you find a solution to so many things that can be adapted to a commercial kitchen.
Exactly.
I say, oh, okay, I can do
you
this
use
at
your
work
brain.
As well.
You use your brain.
Yeah, because at home, you're working with limited resources.
And
you don't have
10 50.
People running around.
Yeah,
you don't have 10 people
chefs.
Chopping, cutting. Yeah. So you find, and you don't have a full pantry. You keep finding replacement, what you can replace with what.
So sensible, practical cooking.
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, a roti bandri, what's happening
roti
there?
Roti bandri, now she's going to put it in a mold. What happened? Can Yeah, you please roll it out. Okay, so the shell will be ready. Let's start with the induction. Is it on?
Do you cook with induction in the hotel, chef?
Only in the show kitchen. I don't believe in inductions.
For drama.
Because nothing like a direct heat.
I agree.
Nothing like a direct heat.
But it works in the pastry sections.
It's easier because it's safer.
Yeah.
It's safer, that's all.
Bhool sakte ho.
Yeah.
So, aap ye ghar pe apne, you can use normal stove, normal fire, gas stove, bilkul theek hai. And you are these very thick, the chapati roti that you're making for the taco? Chef, is it a chunky? Fat?
Sorry?
what you're rolling.
No, it has to be rolled thinner. It has to be rolled thinner, then you'll cut it.
I'm the food police. I wanted chef to use her hands. Dekho, I got her cooking. And how elegantly she rolls. Like an expert. Bahut papad bele hain aapne.
Bel rahi, abhi
bhi bel rahi hai. In a man's world, a woman has to belo papad every day. And she's cutting it with a, yeah, you can see it now.
You can use refined flour, you can use atta, you can have a mix of atta and refined flour. You can have 20% millet and rest all atta, whatever works
for
you.
Jo bhi use karna hai karna.
Whatever works for you.
Ab kya karenge iske saath? Gaana gaate hain?
So this will done while she makes the filling.
Ye kya hai? Coconut milk?
Coconut oil.
Coconut oil?
Yeah.
Ye kyun use kar rahe hain aap?
So coconut oil is a great alternate to, you were talking about refined oil. We discussed that it's better to move away from the refined oils. It's better to move away from these trans fats. So as much as possible, try to add healthy fats in your diets.
So instead of using lard, you're using coconut oil.
Yeah.
Very clever. Because in Mexican cooking, they would have used animal fat. So how wonderful.
You have to put in the mold.
And ये जो भी दुल्हा ऐसा रोटी बनाएगा उसको तो पहले दिन दुल्ही दुल्हन डिवोर्स कर देंगे देखिए then it's actually she's done it well कोई हॉट स्पॉट्स नहीं है अभी and the खुशबू is amazing do you think ये मिलेट की खुशबू
मिलेट की भी है थोड़ा अजवाइन डाला हुआ है उसका फ्लेवर आ रहा है because see millet if the whole world is talking about it and I was on a discussion some time back And they said that let's go 100% millet, but I am not a believer in that. I say even if you replace, you can replace one meal of the day with millet, you're fine. Don't get stuck to
one dish.
One dish, yeah, one dish. That's it. Don't get so dog-headed about it because your stomach will not be able to handle it.
Yeah.
And the way I do it at home is I get my whole millet, I wash it,
so now look at
I sun dry it. And then only I make a powder out of it.
So chef
That's
is
the best
made,
way to help.
You're shaping them, chef, while they're still...
We're just shaping, yeah. This is already done, just to save time. Now we're going to start with the filling.
So coconut oil in a hot pan. We are pretending it's perfect size pan. What happened in it? So, you know, cooking is very adaptive. You have to be mindful in a kitchen and magic happens. Mistakes teach us new recipes. Never be worried. Get into a kitchen to cook, to feed, to share, to spread love. And you'll be the star chef, no matter what you make. I can smell the coconut, ma'am. What are you adding here? Mango what?
I'm adding mango ginger. I thought that was the mic. I'm adding a bit of mango ginger to it. Mango ginger is very unique. This is something from this...
Gujarat.
From Gujarat only.
Itna to kadwa nahi ho jayega?
That's what?
Ye umar ka takaza hai. Not everything good is good in great sums. Moderation is the key, huh?
Yeah, moderation is the key. And also, of course, by experience, you know how much to add.
Oh, wow.
If somebody asks me for recipes, I say, I don't have any recipe for anything. Because if you start measuring things, you will not be able to get the right flavor.
Sabudana. Puffed bajra has been put in. Pearl millet. A bit of crunch.
As I add the guava to this and the prickly pear, it'll get the little sogginess, it'll get the texture. So there's no cheese or anything in it. It's a healthier version of what you can do with what is locally available. I'm just for fashionable thing, I'm calling it a tacos, but it could be anything local.
Wonderful. You know, I was watching a segment where they were making dal dhokli. A Bihari lady was making dal pitti. And this man said, "Hum Gujarat mein isko dal dhokli kehte hain." And the Punjabi woman said, "Hum isko kehte hain, dal bhi kharab kar di, roti bhi, dono kharab kar diye."
I've added a bit of barbecue sauce to this for flavor, just to get that little binding and little flavor, little dense, intense flavor here. Adding a bit of chopped
green chilies.
No, this is dhania.
Dhania coriander.
Dhania coriander.
And depending on who's coming in her home, she adds too much hari mirchi or nothing.
If I don't like you, I'll put lots of green chilies.
That's what she did when I came. I've never eaten at her home. I'm pulling her leg. Chef, what a beautiful... You've used pink guava.
Pink guavas, yeah.
So drama, drama, drama.
Total drama. Total drama.
That's why they call her drama queen in the kitchen.
No. I have another name. Gaurav? I don't know. Gaurav will be able to tell you.
He's saying, no, I need my job.
I've never been a drama queen.
Melodrama queen is what they call it. I can say it while she doesn't have a microphone. We've given you a new name, Melodrama Queen.
Melodrama Queen. Okay, wonderful.
Avocado?
Bit of avocado. Like I said, I'm not a believer of avocado, but I'm just adding it. That's why I want...
To be sexy and chic.
To be sexy and chic, that's all. But you can always avoid it.
So this, you know what it looks like? Undia. Which is in season.
Undio is different, I thought.
But I'm saying, it's a little messy. Ho jata hai na?
That's some compliment.
I love undia. It's in season. Who's eating undia at their homes? So lucky. It's my favorite thing to eat. Oof. It's right now it's in season. Yeah. How lucky you all are to make it. I miss it in North India. Chef, kahan bhag gaya? Now what are you doing, Chef?
Now we're just going to make a salsa and we'll bring all the three elements together. The base is there, the body is ready, and the garnish will come along with the sauce.
And what salsas have you made, Chef?
Salsa, we are doing an avocado and prickly pear salsa. That is what is going to go along with this. And of course, with the pickled green chili.
And salsa is a chutney, you know?
Salsa is a chutney. I mean, there's so many names for salsa all over the world.
And they pack a lot of nutrition. They're very nutrition dense. Khub maze se khaye, jitna kha sakte khaye. So, Chef, do you use what salt do you use in your cooking? Senda, meetha, tikha, namkeen?
At home, it's always senda. At work, in the hotel kitchens, we do use the regular sea salt.
Sea salt use the fancy.
Yeah.
Wonderful. And any brand that you like or Joby?
No, I.
Who's paid you recently to say mera wala lo?
Nobody.
And Chef, does it matter what salt you use? Do you think it makes a difference?
It does make a difference. Each salt has a different effect on the food. So there are times when you find your food something very salty. Go and check your salt label. Maybe you change the salt label. Celtic salt is different. Asian salt is different. All salts have different
properties.
And you
finish with salts too in your kitchen?
You do finish salt. In fact, very typically when I opened Westview at ITC Moria, we would always season, once you grill the meat. You know, in Indian cooking, it's very different.
Yeah,
you do the other way. In Western, you first grill, you sear it, and then you put the salt. Sprinkle. Otherwise, it leaves water.
Which is your favorite salt? Not Indian, say favorite salt. Finishing salt.
Finishing salt would be Asian.
Asian?
Yeah.
Because you're very Mediterranean-centric.
Yeah.
And Maldon, where does Maldon stand?
Maldon is one of the best salts, absolutely.
Like
if you can afford it.
It's so amazing.
Yeah, it's expensive salt, yeah.
So when you're not, we are ready. Okay, what are we doing next?
We're going to do the salsa. I need some more.
So you can grow an avocado tree with the avocado pit. Just put it in a newspaper, brown newspaper bag, and forget it for a while. And the nitrogen in the bag will help it shoot. And they're very friendly in India. They can grow very easily. I have one in my rooftop in Delhi. Yeah. They fruit. And there was a Indian cookbook writer, Julie Sani, in America. She calls it avakaddu. She says, so Indian hai, avakaddu kehte hain. This is now growing in Bangalore. They say it consumes a lot of water, but the Mexicans worship the tree like we do the banyan, and it's a drought-resistant tree. So I don't believe that it takes too much water, Chef, because it can go up. It saves the fruit. The avocado fruit can be saved on the tree. If you have too much, it won't rot. So they worship it because it's very, very smart. Like you know, the alpaca, it does a gestation for 12 months of pregnancy. But if they see that there's cold weather coming or there's a drought about to come, the animal can go 19 months before delivery. Similarly for this tree, the avocatil, the avocado tree, is worshipped because it goes with the temperature and the drought condition in the area where it's growing. So it's a very sensible tree, they say.
I remember one of my visits to Kathmandu, I had seen huge avocado trees. That was the first time in my life.
In Kathmandu?
In Kathmandu, yeah. They're very tall. Huge.
You have one?
Yeah.
Rani Saiba has one. So what is it? Rani avocado tree. So you're adding lime juice into the avocado.
I've added a bit of salt.
Bit of salt. And ye lal cheese kya hai? Beetroot. Oh, with the, yes, with the cactus, the
cactus fruit.
How amazing, look at that.
So
prickly pear.
The
pricks have been removed, and she's adding that into this. She's trying to be very Calvin Klein, Versace, colorful, bright.
Look who's talking.
Look who's talking.
I'm holding the mic.
Okay. So this is what I've done. I've just mixed avocado, tried to create a different kind of a salsa. Salsa is a very broad term. Guacamole, there are so many kinds of guacamole. We only think of one, which is onion, tomato, cilantro, avocado. That's about it. But you can do whatever you want. You can do an orange avocado guacamole or whatever you want. It's all about you have. Yeah. You can do what you have in your pantry. You know, when you're entertaining, don't get stuck to one kind of a thinking. Think out of the boundary and see what you can create.
Do chefs taste?
Doesn't it show?
How important is that, to taste as you go?
Very important. I mean, I don't trust a chef who doesn't eat or doesn't look fat.
Chalo, then you trust me.
Yeah. No, nowadays there's so much of fitness thing, and some very, very great chefs are very, very fit as well. Hats off to them, how they can balance both the sides of the spectrum.
So now you're making another salsa, or this is?
No, I'm just, the filling is done.
Oh, it's done. The filling is done.
Yeah. The filling is done. I'm just going to line up with the lettuce just for roughage a bit here. These are already.
And it's a very important part of a good taco. Either a chopped salad or a green crunch.
Yeah. And it also works as a barrier between the base
taco
and the
thing. Gila nahi ho jayega.
Yeah. Soggy nahi ho jayega even if you eat after some time.
So chef, do you think textures, colors, different tastes like hot, sour, salty, sweet, bitter, when we bite into a dish, does it matter that we give people that variety?
It's very important. For example, Gujarati food also has sugar. It gives you another variation. It gives you another layer of flavor. When you typically in baking, when you bake a cake, you add a pinch of salt.
Yeah.
Because to give you that contrast.
Balance.
So when you make, at home also when I make, I don't tell my kids, I put a pinch of sugar. They don't even know.
Huh.
But then it gives you another angle to what you can taste, you know. So
yes.
Sour, sweet, bitter, astringent, all must go hand in hand. And how to draw that balance is what is chef's job. Not to go over or under one flavor.
We are in Mahatma Gandhi's city. Everybody has to be honest and truthful. I'm told there's one secret you've kept from all your chefs. Woh aaj hame bataein. Kya?
One secret I've kept from my chefs.
Kya unko aapki haath ki safai ek jo aapne kabhi nahi sikhai? Aaj yahan sikha
dun. I don't think I come from that genre of chefs who have potli masala putting in the thing. I come from a different background.
How wonderful. You're an honest chef.
Yeah. And if maybe the style is different, that is something they keep guessing every day. What's chef's mood next day? So they will call up my colleague, "Aaj chef ka mood kaisa hai? What is she going to do?" That used to happen in Maurya. Gaurav will tell me about it.
No, but that's the sign of a true master. You're not afraid to share. You grow every day.
You grow every day. The more you teach, the more you grow. And I learn from my people all the time. I learn from my chefs. I learn from my trainees. That's so important. You keep your minds clear.
अब क्या कर रही हैं आप जब घास फूस दे दी काऊ गाय को चरने
वाली घास फूस का आपने फेस्टिवल रखा है तो घास फूस ही दूंगी मैं
मैं तो घास फूस खाने वाला हूँ, मुझे कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं
है। I hope nobody heard me. I hope I'm allowed to fly back tomorrow.
No, no. I'm a घास फूस खाने वाला, मुझे आपने कुछ इंसल्ट नहीं करा, मुझे आप खिला रहे हैं अच्छा खाना। So, तो अब क्या कर रहे हैं?
So this is just millet galore. So we have a millet tacos. We are topping it up with the millet mix that we had made, which is guava, pearl millet, and a hint of avocado here. And I'm going to top it up with a bit of salsa on top. And this is done. Let's fill up all of them. We are on time?
We are on time.
Yeah, not bad.
आपने slow cooking अच्छी तरह करी.
Slow cooking, fast curry.
Is real cooking.
Slow cooking.
And you did it beautifully. You've shown us how to bring color to the kitchen and to the table. Chef, incredible how you manage being a mom to two kids who are adults and working this very busy job. And you've taught an inventive vegetarian recipe. Jaate jaate ek inspirational cheez bataye.
Well, today is Women's Day, and this question keeps getting asked of me, that how does it feel to be a woman at wherever I am? But like I always say, once I wear a chef coat, I feel no different. I'm part of a team. In fact, I take it amiss if somebody asks me, how does it feel to be a lady chef? Because I think one should be, forget about chef or anything, one should be known for the
work,
the work that they do rather than the gender. You know, that's very important on today's day and age. If we bring up the next generation, we all are mothers and fathers and parents as well. We all have sons and daughters at home. We talk about Women's Day, we talk about equality, we talk about so many other things. But if we start from home and give equal opportunity and equal treatment, I'm guilty of that. There are times when my daughter corrects me, all, you know, mom, you don't expect that from your son, but why are you expecting it from me? So that's important, you know, that's a ringing bell. Like Asma was saying something about I don't remember.
Mother-in-laws.
Now. Mother-in-laws, yeah. So it's so important to treat them
correct
at par. From home. It has to start from
young
home.
Young age.
Organizations can't do anything if the base is already set by the mothers and the fathers at home.
So ye garnish bata de, phir hum logo ko.
So garnish mein humne
isme
thoda sa, we put little sago, fried sago for crunch, and we have some cilantro on top, and it's done.
और मैं खाऊं या बन जाऊंगा?
दांत टूट गए तो मुझे नहीं पता। खाऊं? नाइस। थैंक यू।
फिंगर लिकिंग गुड।
थैंक यू। ओके, दिस इज डिफिकल्ट। क्रेडिट गोज टू हर। थैंक्स।
Thank you, Chef Manisha.
Thank you so much, Chef Manisha Baseen. And that is Chef Suveer Salan for you. Can we have a huge, huge round of applause for them? And Chef, I have a very small question that came into your mind. I wanted to ask you as well. That what advice do you have for aspiring chefs, you know, who are starting off with their culinary careers right now?
See, I do interview a lot of chefs, a lot of young people who come to me. And all of them suddenly want to own a restaurant, want to become chef of a restaurant in 4 years, 5 years. They all want to get Instagrammable pictures they want to create without learning the basics. So if I was to climb this stage and I try to climb from there right on top, I will fall. I have to take step by step by step by step. So that's my advice. Yes, it's good to be ambitious. It's good to be aspirational, but learn the right technique and go the right way. Follow your passion.
Absolutely. And Chef Suveer, do you have words for that?
I mimic the chef, boond boond so ghat bare. So, you know, we in slow motion fill that picture of your knowledge and just take baby steps. That's
fantastic. That's Chef Suveer and Chef Manisha Baseen for you. Can we have a huge, huge round of applause for them? And requesting Mr. Manish Baheti and Mrs. Sonali Baheti to please present them with the memento. Can we have another huge, huge round of applause for them? Thank you so much for adding so much value to the Food for Thought Fest 2024.